Frank Viola, 5-5 for the Mets last year. And Frankie throwing 7 2/3 scoreless innings today, giving up 5 harmless singles by the Pittsburgh Pirates. And what a great story, John Franco coming in and saving it. All the scoring done by the Mets really in the first inning. Greg Jeffries with a home run, his first of the season, and his first hit of the season. Darryl Strawberry with an RBI single. And then in the bottom of the sixth inning, greeting Mike Ressler was Kevin McReynolds, his first hit of the season, and it was a home run. So 4 Mets have homered, and all have been the first hit of the season. As the Mets win it, 3-0. The totals on the game, 3-6-0 for the Mets. As Frank Viola is the Budweiser player of the game, and happily, Frank Viola winning his first game for the New York Mets in the 1990 season. We'll be back with some more of the wrap. Kiner's Korner to follow. Don't forget.
Well, we only had 11 innings work in spring training, but they were quality innings. And, you know, I think it helped throwing the college kids before the lockout ended. So I felt real good out there today. Nice weather to pitch in, too.
Was good. Good pitcher's weather, yeah, all the way around. And, of course, your fastball looked very good.
Yeah, that's me out there today. Last year, I got away from my fastball a little bit, and I got hurt with my changeup and curveball. And then when I needed the fastball in situations, I just didn't have the pop on it. You know, this year, I had an offseason to think about it. And this year, I have to establish fastball to make my curve and changeup effective, and it worked well today.
Certainly did work well. 8 strikeouts in the ball game. Of course, your career high is 11 in any one game. Did that several times.
Right. I'm not an overpowering pitcher, but if I pitch smart, I'll get my strikeouts.
Well, you have to use your changeup and your curveball effectively. You got to establish the fastball.
Exactly.
That's certainly the answer.
And especially in a day like today, you bust them in a couple of times, and their hands will start ringing, and then it'll give you the outside corner of the plate later on.
Let's take a look at some of the action in the ball game. Here's the top of the second. Andy Van Slyke, the batter.
Yeah, I threw a couple of fastballs to start him off, and I came back with the changeup down and had him off stride a little bit. Barry called a beautiful game today. You know, I didn't even shake him off hardly today. And that's how a pitcher and catcher have to work, and hopefully it'll continue the rest of the year.
And you didn't get much of a chance to work with Barry before, have you?
Well, a couple of times last year, but we're just getting to know each other. In spring training, I went out with them the 3 times I went out, and we worked on things, and today it worked great.
Let's take a look at another one. This is Bobby Bonilla. This is the top of the fourth inning.
I think this is another changeup. Yeah, another changeup. Most of my strikeouts, if I get my fastball over, most of the strikeouts will come on my changeup.
Top of the fifth, Andy Van Slyke, the batter once again, and Andy in the opening day game had 2 home runs.
This one Barry called, 0-2 slider. Put it on the black pretty good.
You were on the black all day today.
Yeah,
real
good
control. No walks in the ball game. Top of the sixth, Bonds, Bell, and Gary Reedus, the batters right here.
That was a fun inning. Leadoff man got on base, and that was a slow curveball, inside half. I think it was an 0-2 pitch.
Now here comes Jay Bell.
Yeah, that was a fastball. Fastball on the outside, set him up with a fastball in.
And this is Gary Reedus.
Change up in the dirt, had him fishing. It's a long way though.
really good mixture of pitches right there. The top of the seventh inning, Bonilla the batter again. And of course, these guys they had 17 hits opening day. I mean, you're not pitching to a bunch of little leaguers here.
Well, I think they used them all up.
Maybe they used them all up.
Hopefully, it'll continue. The paddle will continue tomorrow.
And the top of the eighth inning, we have Tom Prince as the batter here.
Another changeup. Yeah, I had pretty good success with the changeup later on in the game because, as I said, the fastball established it early, and Barry went with it and worked out well.
You mentioned earlier in the program that this winter you thought a lot about it. Of course, you came to the Mets, a real big change going from Minnesota to New York, and I'll never forget the game that you pitched when you and Hershiser hooked up. The only time it ever happened that 2 Cy Young Award winners from the past year hooked up in a pitching match, and you beat him in a terrific ball game.
Yeah, it was nice to start. You know, it was nice to save one of your best games for that game. You know, Hershiser is a class pitcher, class guy, and it was nice pitching against him, beating him. But last year as a whole was very frustrating. I really didn't pitch the way I'm capable of pitching. And then coming over to the new league, it was an adjustment trying to, you know, my strong points are learning the hitters in the league. So last year, the 2 months was basically a growing stage for me. But, you know, 1990, new year, new team. Well, looking forward to it.
And how about a John Franco in the bullpen like he had at St. John's?
It's great. 9 years later, we're back home playing for a hometown team, and you're going to see some great games out of him, too. And, you know, the whole team as a whole, we're pulling together, and that's key. And after that first game, I think it really made us come a little closer. And hopefully today we'll take off from here on out.
Frank Viola. And Frank, thank you very much for coming on, and congratulations on a great start.
Thank you very much, Ralph.
And we'll be right back right after this message from NatWest Banks.